So before we get into the candle reviewing, I'm just going to take you on a little trip. I went today to the Hawaii Collectors Wiki show, which just means quick. It's just a one-day show. It was kind of big this year. They had two rooms. They usually only have one room on the one-day vintage shows, rather than the Hawaii Collectors Expo, which runs in a whole weekend. Anyway, I went today, and just really to look around. I wasn't really planning on buying anything or thinking I was going to need anything. And in fact, believe it or not, I left without buying a single thing, which is just fine. Lots of Hawaiian shirts and some muumuus and such at this show. So just take a look at this, and then we'll get into the candles. No, I didn't buy it, but isn't this a great caftan? I love this. Hi everybody, Kai Wazu with you. Welcome back to my channel, and it's time for a little pastime actually for my candle empties video. These are the candles that I burnt during the month of June that passed about 10 days ago. Now I ask you to keep in mind, remember if you didn't know, that these are not candles of my own choosing. This year I'm doing my candle schedule by random roulette. So I just let this pretty random app, I have a inventory of my candles, and I let the pretty random app select what candles I will be burning in the month upcoming. So these are what was drawn for the month of June. So let's take a look and see what I went through. I went through Bath and Body Works and Wicked Apple. I love Apple. Love this Halloween decoration. Really, really great. Maybe a little bit odd in June, but that's okay. Ghostly Green Apple, Creepy Caramel Drizzle, Vicious Vanilla Bean. I don't know. When I'm burning this, I can smell a little bit of vanilla on cold, but when I was burning it, I don't really feel like I smell any vanilla, but I definitely got strong caramel with some, strong apple with some caramel in there also. So it was kind of a mix of caramel and apple. Really nice candle, no issues with the burn. White wax, strong, scent, like a 7, loved it, enjoyed it, would get it again, absolutely. I burned, I'm not even trying to put these together, or like what I burned with what, because I usually have two candles going. I also had a Bath & Body Works Falling Leaves, very pretty container there. Falling Flurries, rather. Sorry, not Falling Leaves. Falling Flurries is, what else would flurries do except fall? I mean, they're not going to go up. I don't know. Anyway, like the packaging. Loved this scent. I think this is the first time I've had this. I don't know if it's the first time Bath & Body Works has. White Wax, 3-wick. Didn't have issues with the burn at all. Frozen thyme, fresh eucalyptus, ripe pear, sandalwood, and natural essential oils. Now, interestingly, I mean, when you read that description, it doesn't seem to say holiday or, you know, winter time or anything, does it? I mean, thyme, eucalyptus, pear, sandalwood. And yet this to me really felt really, really kind of, you know, wintry, Christmassy when I was burning it. Now, I would love for it to have been stronger. It was not super strong. I'd say maybe a 5. Like, I could smell it if I was in the main room. I could smell it if I was kind of standing around it in the area of it. And once in a while, I'd catch a few whiffs of it. But it wasn't really pervading the air. Like, say, Wicked Apple did. However, when I had it burning in the bathroom, which is a much smaller room, I could smell it much stronger in there. And I would walk into that bathroom and just be like, wow, this is a nice scent. It just, despite what it's just, and I'm not saying these scent notes aren't what's there, but it just gave me like a winter forest. I mean, there's a eucalyptus, but there's just like a freshness in this, like a little bit of a you know, watery, snow, fresh kind of note with, I don't know, the pear and the sandalwood, but together, all together, to me, it did really give me a very holiday-like feeling. I really loved this scent. I liked it. I would totally get it again. Absolutely. Would love for it to have been a bit stronger, but... the only, well, I have one other non-Bath & Body Works candle that was drawn last month, but I'm not done with it. We're still burning it, so it's going to be in the next month's empties. But the other one is the line is, well, Colonial Candle Manly Indulgence clearance one. I got at TJ Maxx for $6. So this is in the scent After Hours. Now, this one, I did put on the melter the last couple nights, so the wick did move. The wick was not way over there. It's when it was all liquefied, it moved over, don't worry. This one, I did like the scent. I really wish it would have been a lot stronger. I think it's pretty weak. I'd say 3 or 4. You know, I could smell it if I was standing by it. Even in the bathroom, wasn't, you had to kind of be close to it. And it's just a nice sort of, I don't know, sometimes I find like these sort of masculine scents sort of hard to describe somehow. Well, it says fragrance notes of raw coconut, mandarin leaf, and rustic oud. So I guess the oud is what I'm really getting. I don't know, coconut. Is it really coconut? It's just sort of a masculine, nice scent, masculine wood, cologne-ish scent. Maybe it had some coconut in there, I don't know, but it was nice, just not strong. It did, I will have to say, perform much better when I put it on the melter when it was down close to the end and it just sat on the electric warmer and the scent emanated out actually much better than when it was burning as a candle, so. Take note, maybe next time, if I get that one again, maybe I should just, you know, chunk it up as wax melts to start with, right? And don't even burn it as a candle, and it might do better.
Well, hello there. How's every little thing? I'm Jerry Fontaine. Or maybe I'm Marge Fontaine. Or, I don't know, maybe I'm B Fontaine. Anyway, I'm one of the Fontaine sisters. And I want to invite you to listen to Moody Mood Music on Live365.com. If you enjoy a wide variety of easy listening music, all kinds from small combos to lush string orchestras to great soloists and vocal groups like us, the Fontaine sisters. Just click on the link below, and that will take you directly to Moody Mood Music. Right there in the description box, you can click on that link. And it will take you there to the station that plays the greatest musical variety and displays the greatest number of hair colors. I mean, we're supposed to be sisters, right? I mean, how did that happen? I don't know. We don't have DNA testing yet. Anyway, bye.
Oh. Well, as fate would have it, these two I did burn at the same time. So I have a White Barn iced dragon fruit tea. And this is kind of okay, but boring packaging to me. These lids probably aren't even the right lids I have on here. Tropical dragon fruit, vibrant green tea, lemonade, sweet coconut milk. Very nice scent. Again, I did put it on the melters the last few nights, so it's spread out a little bit more than it was, the wicks. This was nice. Again, yeah, I would like to have been a little stronger. I really like very strong candles, and a lot of Bath & Body Works candles are like 7 and above. But lately, I don't know, a lot of them haven't been quite as strong. So this was more of I'd say a 6, you know, I could smell it. Like it was in the air. It just wasn't as strong as I would like it to be. And it is, I think that's pretty much, the scent notes are pretty decent on that to me. Dragon fruit, green tea, lemonade, coconut milk. There is a slight creaminess to it from the coconut milk. Very nice. It's kind of like one of those bubba teas, you know, bubble teas or boba teas, or I've seen them called all kinds of things, bubba tea. Then, finally, for the large candles, pineapple passion fruit. This one is Bath & Body Works. It's cute packaging. Really nice scent. Loved this scent. Again, I put it on the warmer the last few nights, so the wicks kind of traveled around. But yellow wax, the scent notes read, sweet pineapple, ripe passion fruit, tart cranberries. I don't know about cranberries in this. I don't know. But it's definitely like a pineapple passion fruit kind of scent. I mean, that is definitely something we have around in Hawaii. And it's kind of pumpkin. It's pineapple and, yeah, passion fruit a little bit. It's just like a nice tropical drink, right? Not, you know, smell any alcohol in it. But, yeah, just kind of a nice tropical drink. Now, that's it for the big candles. For the little stuff, I did go through a clamshell of this Woodwick Fireside, which is amber, velveteer, and musk. So nice. Oh my gosh. I can still smell it on here too quite strongly. This was such a nice scent. It's a very pungent fire. I mean, it's definitely like being by the fireside, but there is definitely that spicy, warm spiciness. But not like a food. It's like a potpourri. Like you're sitting by the fire with a fresh potpourri sitting out that. Or tea. I mean, well, not tea. I don't know. Could be tea. This is nice, though. This is just like, smells like what you would imagine. I don't ever do it, but I imagine like being in some log cabin somewhere where there's a bunch of snow happening outside or autumn time, and you're snuggled up in front of the fire with a blanket and a good book or something. So nice. Yeah. I finished up, this was a little cardboard container of wax melts from, who's it from? I don't even know who's it from. Must be under, it was from Ross, $4.99. I don't know, candy cane. Sweet vanilla cream, crushed peppermint, and white chocolate. Yeah, I was kind of hoping it would just be more mint, you know, peppermint. But it's, it is peppermint, but it's a little bit sweeter and a little bit creamier. I've been burning this. I got a couple of pine things going on, and this has been going with it, so it's a nice combination. So these were okay. I've had a couple of different kinds in this box like this from Ross, and they've been okay. They're very small melts. I put like 6 or 7 in a little melter. Then I have just a couple of tarts, Yankee Tarts Wax, Potpourri, and Caribbean Fruit. Didn't smell like anything when I was melting it. Maybe it's old, I don't know. I don't even remember where I got these. I got a bunch of Yankee melts somewhere not too long ago. Must have been in a bag of something from the thrift store, because they don't really have much scent in them. And then Ocean Water. I love the picture on that. I don't know if you can see that very well, but kind of nice. I can't even smell that. I didn't smell anything. I mean, other than I know it was a little bit of a generic sort of oceany scent, but I don't remember. And I can't even smell it at all on here. Except, of course, I get a faint scent of what? Baby powder. It's true. I went through a couple of, just a couple of Bath & Body Works empties. I went through a pocket back of fresh balsam. I have several pocket backs going, so it takes me a while to get through them all. Fresh balsam is one of my favorite scents of all time. It's so strong. I love having hand soap in fresh balsam, because when you're, you know, I mean, I know most places we're kind of not, you know, wearing masks and stuff anywhere, but I still wear them, and most people here and Hawaii still wear them when you're on the public transit, when you're on the bus. You're not required to, but most people do, because especially if you're going to be on there for like 20 or 30 minutes or something. You know, I do. I wear my mask on the bus most of the time. And I'll use hand sanitizers a lot, and I love to use this one. I mean, all of them are great. All the Bath & Body Works ones are great. But Fresh Balsam is so strong anyway. It's so strong. It's like you just pour a little bit in your hands sitting in the bus and like sanitize your hands. And you know everybody can smell that on the entire bus. I mean, it reaches all the way back to the last seat, I'm sure. I love it. I could just keep an empty one, you know, by the bed, or when I'm reading, and anytime I want to feel, you know, like give me a little Christmas forest. And then I went through two hand soaps. I went through a gentle foaming hand soap in Marshmallow Pumpkin Latte, which I don't know, in a way is kind of an interesting scent to have as a soap, but very nice. Marshmallowy. Is it coffee? Is it latte? It is a little bit. More milky, though, I think. More like milky, marshmallowy milkiness. Yeah. And this, now, I didn't realize this is Fiji White Sands, but, you know, I know they stopped doing the antibacterial kind of whatever soap with the little beads in it, although they still have that in these, so why can't they do the bacterial soaps? Anyway, so, but there is gentle hand soap, this kind, which I don't know, like the Fiji White Sands, which is great. I mean, the scent was great and everything, but I don't know if I have any more of this kind. I think the rest I have, I think, are all this kind. The gentle foaming hand soap, as opposed to the gentle gel hand soap. I don't like this stuff as much. I know some people like this better because this makes their hands really dry, but I have no experience with this making my hands dry at all. This didn't make my hands dry either, but it just doesn't, I don't feel like I'm, I feel like I use more of it. I feel like I use it more quickly because that stuff, like you squirt a little bit and it foams up and you just, you know, foam up your hands and you're good to go. This one I felt like, you know, it didn't foam very much and I felt like I was using, I went through it faster and I was using more of the gel because I didn't have the sensation that I was really getting myself clean. I guess just because it wasn't foaming, which is sort of mental, but yeah, so this, I'm not, I mean, the scent was fine, but I'm not crazy about this. I'm going to have to be aware. Well, I have been aware, like, because I did go to the semi-annual sale, like, not to get more of this kind. That I don't want gentle gel hand soap. I want the foaming only, exclusively. But I might have a couple in storage. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, that's it. Please subscribe. Please hit the notification bell if you want to be notified when I upload a new video. And thank you for watching. Let me know if you've had any of these candles or products and your experiences with them, if you like them or not. And I will continue to watch your candle burning videos and melting videos and all of that. So thanks for watching. Have a good week and we'll talk to you later.